Hello, ladies and gentlemen, this is BestInSlot with an educational adventure through the Jurassic period presented to us by the BBC. This game came out in 1998, it's apparently still in beta, making it longer in sort of testing than sort of Duke Nukem and Colonial Marines put together, still in beta, and its high-res version of this download is 20 megabytes. Now, the basic idea is, we go to this map up here, and there are 5 regions. And between these 5 regions, we have to discover these 10 little critters over here. Well, 5 trees, a...
Discover a Jurassic insect. Find a
flying reptile.
Discover an armored dinosaur. Find a giant,
sauropod. And...
Discover a formidable
carnivore. Also in each area, we have to discover these 3 things here. Now, each area will have different things and different numbers of things.
Discover a source of water.
So, in the Mossy Plains, we have to discover a source of water. Now, once we've done that for all 5 regions, we unlock a secret region. It's very exciting. I have done this 3 times.
This is the Jurassic period. 145 million years ago, a world dominated by giants.
I apologize for the crazy sky. I don't know why that's happening.
The great continent of Pangaea, which used to stretch from pole to pole, is now breaking up. These extraordinary monkey puzzle or araucaria trees are well protected against browsing sauropods.
Hello!
So that's a sauropod.
Diplodocus are a kind of sauropod, the largest land animals ever to have lived.
Now, what we can do is we can press T and we can actually hook onto the dinosaur. And then if we press... If we press F1, this puts down
a
camera.
If I then
go into my menu again, we can actually click that camera and get a view off the sauropod. How cool is that? The answer is very... So that's the general idea.
The water that floods these plains has evaporated, leaving just tiny pools.
Okay, that's the puddle one done, as you can see down in the bottom left. Now, we're looking for 2 more in this area. I think one is around here, maybe? No. It's the next one. Yeah, this is the 3rd time I've recorded this. The other 2 times, it simply has...
water in the dry season, and dinosaurs congregate around.
You're loud. You're loud and scary. Hello?
This volcanic feature is called...
You really need to up the volume of the commentator.
In the ground through which steam and gas can...
Because you really can't hear the guy. Hello, beautiful.
The young Diplodocus spend their vulnerable early years...
How are you? You're looking lovely today.
Forest.
Lovely. Let's go.
A dragonfly flies past. They are one of the most ancient types of flying insect.
It's clearly not a dragonfly. It's clearly just some random polygon shapes they've stuck wings on. But like I said, this game was 20 megabytes. It is a teeny tiny 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 game.
This sandy path is a dried up...
It's allowed to do what it wants. Okay, I'm going to have a little explore around. Where are we again? This is the mossy plain. There's another Diplodocus. There he is. Hello, beautiful. How are you?
This giant could be up to 60 or more years old.
Yeah, the other recordings just keep going mental, so I always have to keep recording it, so I do kind of know exactly what I'm doing.
These horsetails quickly colonize any damp patches of ground.
I'm looking for a mossy rock. Ah, it's this thing. It's a rock formation. I think it's this. Yes!
These rocky outcrops, formed by erosion, provide cover for predators stalking nearby sauropod herds.
Oh no, near sauropod herds. Mr. Diplodocus, flee! Nearby predators.
Diplodocus travel in herds of up to 20 animals, a mixture of adults and youngsters.
How exciting! Education and entertainment. It's edutainment. It's entercation. It's something. So, we've done the mossy plains, as you can see we've got 3 out of 3, and now we're moving on to the desert, where we shall see mummy dinosaurs and Egyptians, maybe. Or just Diplodocuses again. And an Allosaurus, hello.
Allosaurus, the lion of the Jurassic
Age. The lion of the Jurassic Age. I mean, it doesn't look like a lion, but that's alright.
Allosaurs have a very good sense of smell, and also listen out for the low rumble of sauropods on the move. Although most of the time they will take easier prey, such as mammals and young dinosaurs.
Oh, I think he's going for it.
A herd of
giant sauropods
on the move is difficult to resist.
Yes, he is. No, he's not. Yes, he is.
Sauropod migration helps to weed out the old or injured. An Allosaurus congregate around the herds, looking for an opportunity.
You a plant? Yes.
Cycads are a group of plants which are flourishing in
Jurassic environment. Hello, beautiful. How are you? It's a Stegosaurus. I shall call it Polly. Hello, Polly.
This is one of the most famous dinosaurs,
Stegosaurus. It is slowly moving backwards. Hello, Stegosaurus.
It is from a group of armored dinosaurs, some of which had spikes as well as plates down the back, or even just spikes.
Spikes as well as plates down the backs? Even just spikes? Oh man, that's crazy. That's crazy. Hello.
There is a patch of strange-looking sand here, surrounded by a lush vegetation.
I'm stuck in sand. I'm drowning.
It is actually fed by an underwater spring below.
Hello, Mr. Stegosaurus.
This makes the sand treacherously soft.
That's heartbreaking.
Soft.
I'm getting out of here. I don't like this area. Stegosaurus, are you okay? Your friend's
the
dead.
The function of the Stegosaurus plates has been a matter of debate ever since they were discovered.
It's kind of cool.
Stegosaurus may have been able to increase the blood supply to its plates, making them flush red.
Yeah, there's only three more things in this area. Leminora. Scared me. Oh, bones. Hello, bones.
The occasional bones scattered around this area may one day become fossils.
Fossils. We're pretending I'm Dr. Alan Grant, or a paleontologist
the
of some sort.
The bare remains of cycads show that a herd of sauropods has passed this way. The shrubby benedictus are very common in this area.
Dr. Ellie Sattler, she may care about plants. She's a paleobotanist.
As the dry season sets in, vegetation becomes scarcer.
Not really my type of thing.
Herds travel further and further in search of food.
Arch, you're on my map, aren't you? If we look. Yep. Look, there it is.
These natural rock arches are formed by wind erosion.
Hello. Hello there. How are you? How
the
are
Allosaurus
you? You look
method
lovely.
Of killing is brutal. They simply run at the sauropods and take bites out of them, leaving victims to die of shock
Hello,
and blood loss.
I need you for my map thing. Come here. Come. Allosaurus, stop slowing me down with your... Where's he gone? There we go.
The pterosaur is flying overhead. These intriguing creatures rule the air in prehistoric times.
Okay, if you look in the bottom, Nora, Mr. the Plodocus, you need to calm down a little bit, bro. Just a little bit, Jesus Christ. How do I get out of here? As you see, if you look in the bottom left, we've got the four things. They're not really that interesting. It's the dinosaurs. We're here for the dinosaurs. Let's go learn more about dinosaurs. Now, the next bit's a little bit violent. So if you are of a nervous disposition, I recommend you look away in about 4 seconds. May take me longer to actually find the bloody thing. If we just nip down here... Yes, we're going down the dry riverbed. Again, I apologise about the sky,
the
it's kind of mental, I don't know why.
Like prints in the mud are those of a Diplodocus.
Is there any prints? Oh, there they are, hello. There it is, look! How violent! It's so gruesome! Nom nom nom. What we're gonna do?
A huge female Allosaurus has just killed a small Diplodocus, which has strayed too far from the cover of trees. If you leave a stakeout camera here, you can watch
so we left the camera
and keep an eye out for scavengers that may follow.
So, oh god, I'm stuck. You get stuck on everything. Look, I walked towards... Oh.
Terrified bellows of an Allosaurus ring out from the area
what?
Of the quicksand.
Find this has never happened before.
On the electronic
Have
field
I seen this
map.
Before? Oh my god, let's go! New news! What's going on? Oh no, the Allosaurus!
An Allosaurus has become trapped in the quicksand. Occasionally, it struggles violently, but this only serves to make it sink more deeply into the sand.
Aww! Leave the camera!
The Allosaurus must have been attracted by the smell of decaying meat.
Poor Allosaurus!
Smaller animals may have been able to scavenge safely, but for the Allosaurus, it might be a fatal mistake.
Oh, it's a little heartbreaking. You okay? I'll get you a rope. Aww. That's really sad. I've never seen that before. That's never happened. But as you see, you can kind of move between your cameras. So if I click here, we go into that one. If I click here, we go into the Allosaurus roaming about. If I click over here, this is scavenger cam.
The tree ferns are a type of fern which form a trunk to grow taller, away from the competition of other ground-level plants. Water from the volcanic slopes above pours down here in the winter.
Nommy, 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 nom. Is it nommy? I bet it's nommy. It looks pretty nommy. It doesn't look that nommy, I've got to be honest. I'd probably pass on eating the Plodocus. I'm just going to put this out there. Anyways, next area, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to my favourite area in the game, the forest. It's awesome. There's actually no dinosaurs in the forest, oddly enough. Excuse me, Mr. Dragonfly. Actually did look like a dragonfly, didn't it? That's impressive. Well done. Hello. I shall call you Poppy too. You shall all be called Poppy. Anyways, I'm a famous paleontologist exploring the wilderness. As you do. We're trapped in the Jurassic era. I love this.
Huge redwood trees dominate the forest on this dry landscape. Beneath them grow ferns, which can tolerate the dark conditions under the canopy.
So much cooler than all the other areas.
This tree has been blown over in a storm.
Ooh.
This mound of earth and vegetation is actually the nest of an Allosaurus. If you set a stakeout camera here, you may catch a glimpse of
it. Now, he says that. He says that. So I always put a camera here. In the two other times I played this, I always put a camera here. I always put one there to look for scavengers. Neither have ever appeared.
There is a lot of competition for suitable nesting sites like this.
It's a pain in the butt, ladies and gentlemen. It is a pain in the butt.
The entrance to a secondary vent of the Great Extinct Volcano is just visible.
Hello.
This has formed a tunnel, just big enough for a dinosaur to explore.
I'm a dinosaur, I can explore.
Stalactites can be seen on the roof of this volcanic vent.
Yeah. I've done this so many times, I can just knock it out.
The tunnel emerges in a volcanic crater.
This is pretty cool as well.
Once the centre of a violent eruption, but now a tranquil area with a beautiful lake.
It has real-time reflections.
The crater catches rainwater. Look. And the lake up here is one of the last areas of water to evaporate in the dry season.
Despite the sky going crazy, it's crazy on the lake as well.
It still gives off heat.
It flickers and stuff.
Steam and other gases rise from the centre of the lake in the cool morning air.
Them pixels, ladies and gentlemen, them pixels. I hope you feel educated, because I don't, having heard this all before. The commentator is really quiet, so it's very hard to get him above the game volume. I hate this, it's heartbreaking.
Flies are gathering above a patch of vegetation.
Flies!
Bzzz. They seem to have detected something on the ground.
They've detected something on the ground. What is it? It's a skeleton.
This little skeleton is all that remains of a mammal. It was a multituberculate. A common rat-like animal living amongst the cycads and gnawing at the vegetation.
A common rat-like animal.
Although some multituberculates were larger and ground-living, this one was a shy creature, only coming out at night. This skeleton is near plenty of water and vegetation, so the animal probably died of old age or from some
illness. Well, that's good. I don't know if you can hear him. I don't know what the volume is going
to be like. The crater is too small to support a population of predatory dinosaurs, so the little mammal's bones have remained undisturbed.
You're saying, basically, the little guy... Oh.
The sound of a rock fall is heard coming from the desert region.
Oh, that's not cool. Basically, he's saying the guy died of old age. Natural causes. Just
find where to go on the electronic
field guide
map. Just trying
about living his life. Happens to die. You know, it's better than being eaten alive by like an Allosaurus or something. Probably. Anyways, up the rock formation we go.
The earth tremor has caused a rock fall in front of the cliff.
We nip round here. We nip to the edge here.
There is now a ramp of fallen rocks.
And we wait for a pterosaur.
Pterosaurs swoop low over the cliff. It might be possible to tag one with a camera and see the world from its
Now, this actually doesn't become available until you've got all the other news things done. Usually, I've got a different news thing by now. Usually, there's a little meteor strike over there, which sounds really exciting, and it's really, really, really not. It is the most boring meteor strike in history.
Pterosaurs are related to dinosaurs and crocodiles, but are actually a separate animal group. Most of the pterosaurs around the plains hunt for insects over the lakes, or those disturbed by the browsing sauropod herds. The sight of a fresh carcass and the promise of easily available meat is usually enough to tempt a few down from the sky.
That is pretty bloody trippy. Mr. Pterosaur, you're crazy, you're crazy! How are you doing? Look at him, he's lovely. You can tell it's a 20 megabyte game. Now, like I say, this is 20 megabytes for the high-res version. So look at the pterosaur, and then imagine what the low-res version of this game could possibly look like. Because I'm having a hard time understanding what it could. I don't know. This, what we're about to get to now, is by far the coolest part of the entire game. You'll see why. But this is... The next bit is what makes this worth playing. And this was, admittedly, quite exciting the first time I played it. Third time, not so much. But basically, like I said at the start, you unlock all the things and you get on the pterosaur and it takes you up here to what is a secret area, the Salt Lake. Come on, Mr. Pterosaur, we shall journey together.
Until now, you have only been exploring the environment. Now explore the behavior of the animals by creating your own herds. You can create Diplodocus by pressing S or L for small or large. You can create Allosaurus by pressing A.
How cool.
The keys are explained in the control section of the electronic field guide.
What I'm gonna do. Gonna make a little herd of
the flat floodplains stretch for miles. In the wet season, they would be giant lakes.
So it's like one, two, three.
As the dry season bites, these start to evaporate, leaving glaring white salt pans. Herds of giant sauropods migrate across the plains, heading for patches of forest which they haven't yet stripped of leaves.
Silly sauropods. Alright, there we go. We've got a nice little... And how cool is this, by the way? You can just make your own little random Jurassic Park. They make you the god of dinosaurs, basically. I am a dinosaur god. Lovely. Basically, we've got a few adults, mainly younger ones. We're going to place an Allosaurus. Boop.
Allosaurus teeth are designed to slice through meat.
Oh, don't eat me.
They're not firmly rooted and are constantly shed.
Please leave me alone. Don't eat me. So, Allosaurus, look. I'm gonna spawn a few Allosauruses. Give them a bit more of a chance. There we go. There's, like, 10.
Young female Allosaurus, already larger than a male would be at this age.
It's like, as soon as you get close to anything, you get caught in, like, a sense of gravity. Look, that's full speed. You just slow down, irreparably, for some bizarre reason. Allosauruses have a center of... Oh, God! Ah! Allosauruses emit gravity. There you go. Bet you didn't know that before. That's a science fact. So there they are, hunting away. Spawn a few more. Give them a hand. The more Allosauruses there are, the more chance we're going to get a kill.
The smaller, duller eye crests of this male show he's still an adolescent.
They say that every time, but I don't think it actually does. I don't think there's actually any difference between the models, personally. Hello. Goodbye. I love how they attack, though. They attack like you'd imagine... Like, you watch Jurassic Park and you see the raptors attack, and they attack the same way. Now, they often just bounce off the Diplodocus for some bizarre reason, but I assume that's just because they can't get a grip. Look at them, like, you see what I mean? Like that. It's a very raptor type of attack. It's like you jump up and the claws go in and legs come up and stuff, and it's like a monkey. Marg. Oh, don't eat me, don't eat me. I don't think they can eat me, but I'm still... Why are you attacking the big one? Look, there's lots of little ones, delicious little babies.
The sauropods are alarmed by the presence of the Allosaurus.
Eat the delicious babies, not the delicious parents. Allosaurus, I'm going to spawn as many as humanly, but I don't know. Basically, the game's over by this point, pretty much. So I am slightly curious as to whether I can break it by spawning too many dinosaurs. I've never tried that before, so let's find out. Allosaurus, Allosaurus, I had an Allosaurus. His name was Al. I'm stuck. Meh. Too many Allosauruses. Far too many Allosauruses. I'm trapped in a cage of Allosaurus. In a cage of my own doing. Oh, what irony. The dinosaur god trapped by dinosaurs. What are the odds? I'm quite high when you're spawning like 50 Allosauruses. Get off me. Meh. Meh. Okay, that's enough Allosauruses. That's an inordinate number of Allosauruses right there. Let's have a few more. Spin on a circle. Hello.
By getting the herd moving, the Allosaurus can pick out any stray youngsters or slow-moving
They can
adults.
Get a kill. I've seen it happen before. They're just not very good at doing it. They take their time, to say the least. But there's many, many Allosauruses. This size herd is never going to sustain this many Allosauruses. They're going to have to meet each other. Which won't be that hard, because they keep falling over, so... Not me. Just bouncing off every time. It's ridiculous. Silly Allosaurus. Oh, I thought that was a kill then. Okay, I'm sorry that Mr. Diplodocus is that I kind of spawned you just so you can die for my entertainment. Usually I don't like killing dinosaurs, but I do like seeing dinosaurs eat other dinosaurs. Is that... Oh, God. that was it's the angle of the head. It's just, yeah, that's not PG-13, that's not science, that's not dinosaur facts. I will give you instead a dinosaur fact that this game taught me. Did you know Stegosaurus has lots of very small bones just under its skin to act as protection, apparently, according to this game? The game may be lying to me for all I know. It's not the most trustworthy game in the world. Oh, they got a kill. Nip over here. That's kind of heartbreaking. I'm sorry, Mr. Diplodocus. Let's get out of here. Where's the camera map? Let's go check on our nest. Has anyone popped up? Nope. Are you actually sinking at all? I can't tell. I don't think he is. Hello. Hello, Mr. Stegosaurus. Look.
Stegosaurus is famous for having a very small
brain. For moonwalking.
About the size of a walnut.
If we just hang around the dinosaur, it keeps giving us new facts.
Stegosaurus is around 7 meters
long. Let's learn
long,
about the Stegosaurus.
Almost half of which is made up of its
that's
tail.
Of course, shut mouth on this.
Its body is well protected by a line of bony plates and 1 meter long tail spikes.
It looks like he's got like...
Its throat skin is also toughened with little embedded bones like chainmail.
Chainmail? Oh. More facts!
Stegosaurus is a herbivorous
dinosaur fact!
Having quite short legs, it strips low-growing vegetation, such as ferns.
So many facts. More!
The Stegosaurus uses all its defensive weapons to their best advantage. By turning sideways towards an attacker, its plates make it look bigger than it really is.
Science!
Its thrashing spiked tail presents a formidable problem to its attacker.
I totally love being the voice recorder for this game. It'd be amazing. Is that it?
Although familiar to dinosaur lovers, Stegosaurus is a rare find. There are only around 10 well-preserved specimens in the world. Several of them come from the Morrison Formation in North America.
Oh my god, go away. I wonder how many different lines about Stegosauruses this guy's had to record. One more? Any more? Oh, that might be it, actually. We've exhausted the game's knowledge on the Stegosaurus. Oh well. The Morrison Formation, now that he mentions it, that was actually in Jurassic Park Builder. Jurassic Park Operation Genesis. Genesis, I should say. And while you're here, dinosaur lovers, because if you're still watching at this point, you must really love dinosaurs. Jurassic Park Operation Genesis will be coming back to the channel in a way sometime within the next few months. So there you go. There's a bit of insider news. Hello, Mr. Diplodocus. Let's do a quick check of our cameras. You're looking okay. You're still no scavengers. You're not doing anything. You're just dying slowly. And you're trotting about being happy with yourself. Lovely! Ladies and gentlemen, that was Dinosaur World, an educational trip through the Jurassic period by the BBC. I will link the game in the description of this video. You can all go download it. It's 20 megabytes, it'll take you about 2 seconds, if that.
Allosaurus lead a rough life, and injuries such as this leg wound
are common. He's been crippled!
For a running predator, an injury like this can have severe consequences.
Oh no, Mr. Allosaurus! I've never seen that before. Are you okay, Mr. Allosaurus? You don't look okay, you're not doing that well. Oh. He's gonna die. That's kind of heartbreaking. Oh. Look at him. Little crit. Oh no! Mr. Allosaurus! Oh no. What are you doing, sir? What are you doing? He died! He's my camera. I don't need a camera on him anymore. Why do I want a camera on a dead Allosaurus? Don't know, but I do have one. Oh, Mr. Allosaurus, I'm sorry.
The mother Allosaurus who made this nest needs to guard her eggs carefully.
Where is she then?
She will defend her nest against any animal which comes too near.
But she's not here!
When the eggs are ready to hatch, she will be able to help them dig their way out of the
hard earth. There's not even any eggs in the blimmy thing. I've never seen a dinosaur in this region. I kind of wish I could. It's not... Oh, bloody hell. Come on! Mummy dinosaur, where are you? I think they're lying, you know. I don't think it ever appears. I'm not sitting here waiting. I do love this area though, it's really atmospheric. All you need is a bit of fog. It doesn't have to be slightly good fog, and you make any area just look awesome. Conifers. Especially when the trees just go for miles. Miles! Come on, Mummy Allosaurus, where are you? She's not coming, is she? Let's go check on off. No, she's not happening either. Nom 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 nom. I wonder what the scavengers would be. They'd have to be the Allosaurus. I don't think they'd conceal another dinosaur from me. No, they wouldn't. Oh well. With this lovely shot of the Allosaurus eating the Diplodocus, because that's what we all want to see before we have our tea and such drinks, I'm going to leave you there. So this has been Dinosaur World, an educational trip. I hope you all feel educated. Probably not. I doubt you can even hear the announcer guy, because he's very quiet. But still... See you lovely people in the next episode. Cheers, much love, bye bye. If you've not fucking